30 years ago, British researchers made a key discovery. The immune system of Crohn's disease patients holds a grudge against baker's yeast. Main and colleagues compared antibodies in Crohn's patients' blood to those of healthy controls. In Crohn's, antibodies readily bound to baker's yeast, but in controls, little binding occurred. These antibodies were binding to three cell wall components which are present on all fungi. Main and colleagues proposed that Crohn's could be caused by immune hypersensitivity to baker's yeast itself, or to another microbe, which shares baker's yeast's immunological fingerprint. At that time, cell culture was used to detect fungi. Two types of fungi were found to be prevalent in the gut, baker's yeast and candida. Because of these findings, baker's yeast and candida have been among the usual suspects in Crohn's research. However, strong associations with these fungi have not been found in microbiome studies. Recent advances in DNA sequencing enabled these studies to find a third candidate fungus, Malassezia. Prior to these advances, studies couldn't detect Malassezia because they don't grow well in the lab. Malassezia are best known for living on our skin and causing dandruff. Antifungal shampoo kills Malassezia and eliminates dandruff. Until very recently, researchers believed that Malassezia could only live on our skin. Many studies now report that Malassezia are also present in our guts. Two groups found strong associations between Malassezia and inflammatory bowel disease. Could Malassezia be the culprit? Antibodies against fungi in Crohn's aren't specific and bind well to many species, including Malassezia. An immune response against Malassezia in the gut could explain why these antibodies are so strongly associated with Crohn's. If we could kill Malassezia in the gut, would this lead to remission as occurs with dandruff? A small study tested this with the antifungal drug itraconazole. They reported remission in 4 out of 5 Crohn's patients, despite discontinuation of other therapies. It's possible that an effective treatment for Crohn's has been sitting on pharmacies' shelves for 30 years. We simply didn't realize it. This has happened before. Stomach ulcers can be cured using antibiotics developed in the 50s. However, researchers didn't realize until the 90s that these ulcers were caused by bacteria in the stomach and that a round of antibiotics could cure patients. We want to redo the itraconazole study with more Crohn's patients to confirm that it's right, and we can't wait to start. Share this video with the hashtag Malassezia to help us get the word out. If you'd like to make a difference for patients, click here.